Good evening. The daughter of wife killer Chris Dawson has stared him down in court, begging him to reveal the location of the body of her mother, Lynette. The judge is now preparing to sentence him for the 1982 murder after finding Lynette would never have left her children of her own free will.
The daughter, Lynette Dawson, would never have abandoned. Chanel Dawson embracing family at the New South Wales Supreme Court, preparing to face her killer father for the first time since his conviction. In court today, she stared down 74-year-old Chris Dawson, seated in the dock.
The night you removed our mother from our lives was the night you destroyed my sense of safety. Because of your selfish actions, we will never see her again. We will never hear her tell us she loves us. I had to explain to my beautiful, innocent daughter why her grandfather killed her grandmother. She kept asking me, but why did he do that? Why didn't you just divorce her? Let those who love and needed her keep her.
Lynette's body has never been found. A judge finding the former teacher murdered his wife to pursue an unfettered relationship with the family's schoolgirl babysitter. It was a brazen act of a conniving monster, hell-bent on one thing, getting what you wanted at any cost.
The thing I want from Chris Dawson is to tell him where my sister is.
Chris Dawson attended court in person wearing a dark green prison tracksuit and didn't have a single supporter in court. He kept his head bowed for most of today's hearing and kept it down as his daughter addressed him directly. Crown Prosecutor Craig Everson, SC, said Dawson had shown no remorse and done substantial harm to others. His defence lawyer Greg Walsh argued the murder wasn't in the worst category and asked the judge to consider his client had endured the most constant and egregious publicity ever seen and to take his poor health into account.
He's very ill and he has a problem with his brain. It looks like he's got dementia.
Dawson will be sentenced on December the 2nd, this afternoon heading back to jail with his daughter's plea ringing in his ears.
Please tell us where she is. I hope you will finally admit the truth to yourself and give us the last bit of closure we need to make at least partial peace with this horrible tragedy.
Emma Partridge, Nine News.